For about the past 15 years, there has been a wide variety of turntables and cassette players with a USB output, allowing you to easily transfer your records and audio tapes into digital form. But what about videotape? There are a plethora of USB video capture devices which can be connected to your camcorder or VCR, but what if you don't have one or it doesn't work? Of course, these days, there aren't any more new VCRs or tape-based camcorders being manufactured, so asking for a new one is out of the question. But even when they were still being made, the concept of a device which can play your old videotapes and easily connect to your computer to transfer them into digital form was virtually unheard of. There was the Ion VCR to PC, which was in production from around 2008 to 2010. But first of all, despite the name, it's not actually a recorder, it's just a player, and it's just a combination of the cheapest possible two-head mono non-hi-fi VHS mechanism and an off-the-shelf USB video capture circuit board stuffed into the case. So you'd get better results using almost any VCR and any video capture device. Sony did have one model of analog Hi8 Handycam with a USB output, the CCD-TRV-608, which was introduced in 2002 and cost around $400, but its USB output is limited to a resolution of only 320 by 240, and the drivers for it don't work with anything newer than Windows XP, so it's not a high quality or practical solution. Besides those two, there's only one other analog video device that I know of with a USB output for transferring the video from it into your computer, and you're looking at it, the Samsung SCL770 Hi8 camcorder from 2002. 22x zoom lens and 880x digital zoom, and here they mention Hi8 PAL AV signal output, which is another unusual feature. And then finally here, internal USB. Other special features include a video light, external microphone input, remote control, digital image stabilizer, digital special effect. They sell these digital everything, but it's actually an analog recording camcorder. PIP, I guess that means picture in picture. Snapshot, which probably just takes a still frame to tape because this doesn't have any kind of memory card in it. Backlight compensation, auto or manual focus, and finally the last feature they mentioned is USB. And there it says it was manufactured in April 2002 in Korea. Inside the box, we get a Samsung camcorder accessories brochure. The manual, which lists several different models. This was the top-of-the-line model from Samsung from 2002. And it looks like the original owner wrote this in there. So, have to look through that. And the USB driver on a CD-ROM. This will definitely come in handy because I'm sure I can't find this online anymore. We also get one sealed blank Hi8 tape. I don't know if this originally came with it or just something the eBay seller threw in. We get the power adapter. Remote control. Looks like those batteries still have some life left, but just in case they don't, here's a sealed coin cell battery for it. Shoulder strap with the Samsung logo on it, and a couple cables, and finally the camcorder itself. The camcorder does have the original Samsung lithium-ion battery, and it does seem to hold a charge. And interestingly, it has one of these slide tabs which you can use to indicate which of your batteries are charged or discharged if you have multiple batteries. And here are the cables that are included. An AV cable with composite video output and mono audio output because this is not a stereo camcorder. A USB cable. And this weird looking audio cable which goes from the AV output of the camcorder to a standard stereo headphone type input. And the point of this is, the USB is only for video. It does not transfer the audio, so you will also need to connect this to your computer's line input. And at first glance, the camcorder looks like nothing special. Looks like almost any other Hi8 camcorder of the early 2000s. Get a lens cap, we get a halogen spotlight. That's the sensor for the remote control. And there's a single mono built-in microphone. You can see they had space for another one, but it's not included. And there's that lens of what looks like a focus ring, but it's not, it's just a decoration. Get a flip-out LCD. See if I can turn it on here. And yes, it does come to life. And the zoom works. But we also get a black and white viewfinder. Some buttons and a dial for going through the menu and adjusting the focus. There's the built-in speaker. You get a fader, backlight control, DSC, I guess that's digital still effects or digital special effects. It has the tape playback controls on the top, eject button, a button for turning on the light. There's that halogen spotlight. And I do like how the tape compartment opens from the top. Unlike many later Sony models, where it opens from the bottom, requiring you to take the camcorder off a tripod in order to load or unload a tape. There's your main control switch, recording button, AV output. And there's the S video output and the power input. There's the tape compartment, hand strap, and external microphone input, which is nice to have. And finally, the USB output. I have it connected to my TV's S video input, and I can tell the resolution of the camcorder's image sensor is not the greatest, but the contrast is nice and sharp, and the colors are accurate. And here are those digital special effects it has. Ghost, which gives a trailing image. Strobe, which makes the motion look choppy. Sepia, black and white. Negative. Mirror, I like that effect. Art, which gives it a solarized effect. Mosaic, 16:9, and if this was a widescreen TV, it would show it at the correct aspect ratio. Cinema, which adds black bars to the bottom and top, and back to normal. But I'm wasting too much time here on these different features, which you can find in any Hi8 camcorder from the early 2000s. Now I want to try that USB output. I'm going to be bold and try it on my 64-bit Windows 10 computer. If that doesn't work, I can always fall back to a Windows XP machine. Hey, come back here. What? It's just closing by itself. Well, now, well, when I want it to close, it won't. What's going on with this drive? Unknown publisher. Aha! Samsung USB Media 2.0 installation program. Well, I don't know what this motion detector is, or motion picture coordinator. Photo Suite 3 SE is probably just some kind of cheap photo editing program. So I'll just install the driver and the player. See if it works. Remove the USB cable before installing. Okay, I didn't even plug it in yet. Installation failed. But it's still doing something else here. Alright, it added USB Media 2.0 player to my desktop. Let me try plugging in the camera. Well, the camera is plugged in and turned on. If I switch my TV to the S video input, you can see the image from it. If I switch back to the PC, we just get a blank screen here, and we have an unknown device in the device manager, which is probably the camera. So I don't think we're going to have any luck getting this to work in Windows 10. Looks like the software would work, but the driver isn't. Now I'm using my trusty U310 keyboard PC. So this isn't just a keyboard, it's the entire computer. Samsung camcorder USB. Looks like it worked. So let me try this USB thing. Do we get an image? We're getting an hourglass. I want to see more than that. Aha! So here's what I got. A whole bunch of pictogram icons. Multi-snapshot. Capture red image list. I think they meant captured image list. Delete the multi-captured images. Snapshot. Send images by email. A recording button. This is the options menu, I guess. Okay. Capture type MPEG or AVI. Capture size 320 by 240. I can increase that to 640 by 480. MPEG files not supported. So if I change it to AVI, can I do that? Okay, frame rate 24 frames per second. I want to make that 29.97. I don't have that audio cable plugged in yet, so I'll just do video only. And I'll put the video quality on high. Well, certainly made the preview window larger. See if I can record anything. Cap1.avi. Alright, is it working? Hello? And here's our captured video. Well, discover when you capture using that Samsung program set to AVI at 640 by 480 resolution, it's capturing uncompressed bitmap video with a bitrate of 155 megabits per second. And even with an SSD, that's just too fast for this system to handle without dropping frames. So we can see we're not able to get the full 29.97 frames per second out of it. Using a faster Core 2 Duo machine, I was able to capture video from it at 640 by 480 resolution without dropping a lot of frames. And here's a sample of what that looks like.
Spencer. Merry Christmas, Spencer. Hello, Spencer. Spencer.
And if you're wondering if the video going through USB while the audio is a direct connection will cause the audio and video to get out of sync, the answer is yes. Yes, it does. And since USB is buffered, the delay is not consistent. For example, here's a scene I captured twice using exactly the same settings, and the amount of lag between the audio and video varies each time.
That's it. That box.
Oh my god, Tony! I love this! Oh my god, we actually see what I got.
I saw a little bit of it. I heard what it was.
That's it. That box.
Oh my god, Tony! I love this! Oh my god, we actually see what I got.
I saw a little bit of it. I heard what it was.
I tried a whole bunch of different video capture programs trying to find one which will let me capture high quality video without requiring a very fast machine and producing enormous file sizes. The solution I found is called AMCap. The latest version of it no longer supports Windows XP, but I was able to find an older version which still does. And in this program, when you set compression to none, that does not mean it's capturing uncompressed video. Instead, it's capturing the video exactly as the camcorder is sending it over USB. That turns out to be a proprietary motion JPEG codec from WinBond, which was common back in the early 2000s when USB didn't have enough bandwidth to capture uncompressed video. So all that Samsung really did was take one of their standard Hi8 camcorders and add in a WinBond USB video capture device. And the way I can tell is that it works even with the camcorder not turned on. In fact, I don't even have the battery installed. So there's no power to this camcorder, but yet if I plug in the USB cable, the computer recognizes it right away. So that video capture device is actually powered by the computer through USB, not by the camcorder. So if I took this file and tried to copy it to any other computer, it wouldn't play because it doesn't have the matching driver. And even on this computer, which does have that driver, it doesn't work so well. For example, in Windows Media Player, I get an upside down and rapidly flashing image. So obviously that's not usable, and VLC refuses to play it because it doesn't support that WJPEG codec. So this is a perfect example of why I scoff at the people who tell me I should archive my tapes into digital form. No, the tapes are my archive. Because imagine I had gotten one of these camcorders 20 years ago and used it to transfer all my Hi8 video recordings into the computer and then threw out the tapes. I'd be stuck with proprietary video files which don't work on any computer which doesn't have the matching driver and don't even play reliably on a computer which does. And these days I know there are people who are looking for old camcorders to record new videos which look like they're from the 80s or 90s. And in that case I'd say this Samsung SCL770 is perfectly fine for achieving that goal. I would just recommend forgetting about this built-in USB output and instead use a high-quality, properly supported USB video capture device such as this Dazzle DVC-100. Here's a sample of my workbench recorded on Hi8 tape using the Samsung SCL770 from 2002.